Welcome back to AT Race. This is week 249, day 2 of Chaos Season. And yeah, let's begin with our battle. I did change the last team. I'm going to see if I maybe we play with this. A Zane, power up by Fjorm, Diamond, and he'll get rest from Elamin. But yeah, attack and speed easily lets him go all the way. We'll see. I don't think I'll use it, but if the opportunity shows up, then we might go for it. This one is interesting. Altina. Altina can be tricky, especially with a Cecilia. Not Cecilia, Celica. I don't think we have any save skills at all. Can Diamond one-shot Altina? And even if he could, then I'll have to deal with Celica, which means this Altina goes over here and gets dance and then attacks me over here. I don't like that. I mean, with this, I can stop the dance. That's the same team as yesterday. We do need to avoid Twin Blades. Because obviously it bypasses damage reduction. 46. 50% of 46 is 23. Yeah, we'll just say 23. 59. We proc Frost Mirror on the first hit, that's the only thing. We don't proc it on the second hit. So the first hit shouldn't do any damage. I mean, it will do damage, but shouldn't do much damage because of all the damage reductions. But the second hit is the one that we'll have to live through it. Death Rest minus 7, but I don't think she eats it. 36, 36. Four, no, you eat it. And then for Regan, I guess she could kill Azura. I mean, Ash. Is this Celica's more dangerous than anything else? Like, for me to just go in there. Because with this team, I can do a lot of shenanigans with the double warp. Like, jump, then jump, then jumps, and jumps, and jumps. But I think I'm gonna go with this team. Well, I'm pretty sure the first team is better. But we're gonna go with this team. Alright, three spaces, five movement. One, two, three, four, five. She can move all that. So I do wonder. If I could just punch Altina in the face. And then, I don't know, handle Lucina with Ash. She doesn't have a damaging special, so. We'll do it like this instead.
I will not lose my way.
We'll carve a path.
Like this. I couldn't do this. Then put you over here. Then put you over here. And then move you here. And yeah, we'll go with this way. Because if anything, I still have a way to get.
I see a way forward.
I feel faint.
To get.
I do not object.
Ash out of the way, just in case.
Truly? Here I go.
Oh yeah, we can do that.
As you request.
Guess I should have put them the opposite way. Would have been a little better. So I wait one more turn. That way I can set up.
I feel faint.
I can set up Guinevere to be in a good healing position. We'll wait that one turn. Alright.
Lord Asker, guide us. So hot.
Yeah, this time we don't even take any damage. Alright. Bring it on, Celica. Or Azura. How much damage is this gonna do? 128. Alright, so we won. I guess Idun we could leave for
as you request. I do not
Ash to handle.
I feel faint. I will go. I will not lose my way. Speak. Truly?
Is there a problem?
Here I go. I will go.
You can stay there.
I do not object. So hot.
I see a way forward.
Poor Ike. Used to be the king of Ether Raids. How the mighty have fallen.
I will not lose my way.
Effective against dragons. Yeah, just dragons. You don't have effective against beasts. Alright, I got both Aether, so I'm still missing Aether. No, I got both Aether.
Lord Asker, guide us.
I feel faint. Speak.
Truly?
We'll carve a path.
Here I go.
Alright, here we go. And yeah. Sorry, Yuzina. And yep, we got our bonus skill. Alright, for defense though, we did get minus 40 on this one. It was pretty close. In fact, like, it all comes down to this. This right here. This Demon Maria. That's the only reason why they were able to win. Well, that what they were able to get out without even losing a unit. But, aside from that, they have this. This Aether, which is extremely powerful. Brave Edelgar, Elamine, and Freyr. So remember that she has no follow-up, Aether. And they are running a damaging special, which is smart because Gale Force is not good. Against Freyr, I mean, like, it's good, but against certain things like Freyr. Alright, back up. Medeus. Yeah, just look at her stats. 26, 20, 26, 26, and 23. Now she is a full health. Just pay attention to this part. She is a full health, fully buff. Now Ninian obviously cannot get past her damage reductions. But here comes Diamond. And yeah, that 1 HP means that she got saved by Maria. Now, I don't know if he actually one-shots her from full health, but the fact of the matter is that he nearly one-shot her at full health. Or they would have lost without Maria right here. Now, my Ninian is also the recipient of Miracle. So it's not like I'm not also taking advantage of Miracle. Now their Edelgar is far safe. And Sephia can't really do much damage to him. Now Ymir is really, really slow, so she gets naturally doubled by everything. So yeah, Freyr takes us out right here. And from this point on, there's not much Zephia can do. She's already doing zero damage to this Edelgar, who has plus 26 res, and I'm getting a minus 7 attack. So 26 plus 4 story, 33 damage differential right there. Stat differential. And yeah, the goat takes us out. But yeah, if it wasn't for that Maria right there, we would have definitely killed that Aether. Now this one is a very weird team. So they have this Eremia, plus 10. Close foil, chill attack, distant guard, live to serve. A plus 10 for Mortis, but no seal. A plus 4 Robin with armor merch. So to move this other two around, because they had this plus 10 fallen Edelgar. And then there's this Snowy. Attack speed solo 1, vantage 2, defense plus 3, rally defense, new moon. I don't know if they just like grab all the Noes that they had and just like merge them to get a plus 10 Noe, and then just didn't bother to give skills just to have like a bonus unit, because this is, what is this even? Yeah, this is like the weirdest kid on a plus 10 max flower unit. But yeah, so Freyr goes in. Not quite able to take out Fallen Edgar. Because can't double her. But it did let us take out this weird Noe. Who, yeah, I don't get what this Noe is. Like, why even merge her all the way up? Give her max flowers if you're just gonna give her a kid like that? Like, at that point, just bring a 4-star, that's it, if you just want her for a bonus unit. So not quite able to take out Diamon, or do anything to Diamon. Now they left Freyr alone, which is terrible, because he has Ignis ready. And just one shots their fallen male Grima.
I'll prove my worth.
And then Diamon just one shots Edelgar. And Ninian finishes off Eremia. So yeah, it's just a trickle effect right there. They still had their 4 Mortis, but... this point, not much they can do. Their ball tower didn't hit anybody other than Diamond. Now, minus 25 attack and minus 25 defense. That minus 25 defense is important because bonfire. That's over 12.5 boosted damage is taken away from Bonfire. And yeah, we took out their Fomortes. And then finally, this one, which just came in. You have Duo Asker, Christmas Chicken, Summoner Supported Break Chrome, Legendary Azura, and Ash. And yeah, like we saw with the yesterday with the Karel, they're gonna try to attack from the left side. I mean the right side. So this phase getting hit with every debuff under the book. So this is why Cepheus is actually able to do plenty of damage to her. Or, you know, when she doesn't have Aegis up. Not quite able to take out Cepheus, but Cepheus couldn't take out Faye either. And yeah, here we go. We've seen this plenty of times. No one is stopping the dance.
Such disgrace.
So Diamant just goes and takes it out. And then there's this right here. Which Ninian takes out Asker. And their bolt tower wasn't able to hit, do anything since the only two that weren't protected by it are all the way on this side, and all four of them still have Angar on them. So even though they had a 52 damage bolt tower, we got no damage from it. But yeah, pretty good so far. I mean, this one, not much I could do, although if people have more aiders, then I am gonna have problems with it, because she's really strong, especially with that A slot of hers. Now, for summoning, I haven't done it yet, but I will probably be summoning right after this. We have a few days for this one, but we'll just get our unit right here on the summoning. We have all our tickets. And we have plenty of banners to summon on, including these two, but we probably won't summon on those. We'll summon on everything else, use all of these tickets that we have. But that will be on a separate video. And for this one, thank you all for watching. I'll see you all next time. Bye.